spray can it with car paint when you were a big Billy Idol fan. That's
I was a big Billy Idol fan, I admit, and my punk name was Johnny Spasm. Yeah, I'm proud of it. I'm here to rock and roll, ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you that much. I did, yeah, and it's still with me, fortunately. But let's go back to the...
So you've still got a sense of humour, anyway.
Almost. Let's go back to the accent. Has it changed the way you feel about things? I mean, I know it was a particularly nasty scrape, and, you know, it could have been worse than it was, obviously. Have you changed your life because of it in any way?
Well, it doesn't look like it, does it?
No, it doesn't look like it, but I'm asking you whether it has or not.
I don't know, not really. I mean, thank God I had a life that I was already enjoying to get better for.
Now, I read one quote that your mum said that you are now, as a result of it, you're now a born-again Christian.
Yeah, I think you heard her wrong. It wasn't born again, I was into porn again. You're reading Hustler!
But only Christian porn, I should imagine.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
I should hope so. You don't go down with me. Well, let's go back. You mentioned I was a punk. I mean, I was a particularly ineffectual and weedy one, but I was something of a punk.
You still look a bit like that.
Ineffectual and weedy. But I kind of miss those days. I look back on them with nostalgia. Is there anything about them that you miss?
Well, I'm still sort of living it out, really. So, you know what I mean? Music was what I wanted to be involved in then, and ended up still doing it now.
Well, let's have a look. We're going to look at some of your latest work in a minute, but I'd like to look back on those halcyon days, if I may, when you were, of course, the lead singer of Generation X, and this is, I think it's Wild, Wild Youth we're going to show. Now, for a start, you're not going to be looking at yourself. Now, as I said, I was a bit of a punk, and I don't think it was my parents' proudest hour.
So what, you're going to ask me these questions?
I've got all those questions over there, Billy.
You can't ask your own questions.
Earlier. What do you mean? I did them myself earlier. What did your parents think of that period? I mean, what did they think of you being a punk?
Well, I think... my dad really hated it at first, but once I got the record contract, he kind of thought a bit differently. Right, ask the next one.
Oh, no, don't... But don't you go getting bossy on me, Billy. So, now, Generation X school split up, and you went on... I mean, really, I know they've all done other things, but you're the biggest success story out of them. Just throw him away, will you? Because he's going to keep looking the wrong way. But you went on... Now, why do you think you went on to the biggest success? What was it about you that allowed you to survive? Because Generation X weren't, like, the most credible of punk bands.
Well, I don't think that's got anything to do with it. I think all the people I know are still making music, and that's all that mattered. We only did it for a laugh and for the fun of it and the hell of it. And that's probably why you liked it. Just rather like, I expect you're grooming yourself to take over from Tell right now,
No.
No?
I've got a lot of weight to put on first before
I lose a bit of hair, I suppose.
Why did you go to the States? I mean, how did you come to resettle over there?
Well, once Generation X broke up, it didn't seem much use just hanging around being somebody who was a bit of a has-been. It seemed a lot better to go somewhere else where, as far as I knew, I was a complete non-entity and start again. That's what I did.
And did you have to... I mean, obviously, you said something. Did you have to change much
you
about your image?
You look at my balls or something. I keep thinking... it keeps looking right at me. I mean, you know, Jonathon, if I knew you were like that, I'd take a bit... No wonder you like Generation X.
All I was doing...
We were the prettiest.
I'm a fan of his. I just wanted to check you hadn't lost anything in the accident, Billy. As simple as that, and as innocent as above all of that. Let's have a look. Before it goes rapidly, Daddy, let's have a look at... This is your newest single, isn't it?
Yeah, that's right.
L.A.
Yeah.
Woman. Have a look at this.
It's a hilly, warm Sunday afternoon. I see you riding your suburb into the old blue. In the old blue.
Yeah, but...
Oh, well.
And that, of course, is fine.
Right. So any moment now, you're going to get a little bit of the... Whoa, and a bit of all that, so it's a bit of a shame. Can't you play a bit more?
Not on this show, you can't, no. That's for your new album, Charmed Life, which is often on my turntable at home, even on my CD thing. But it's your first album for about 4.5 years. I mean, you're not exactly prolific. Why does it take you so long?
Well, I think you said it. Generation X weren't the most... what was it you said?
Incredible.
Incredible of punk bands. So why the hell should I put a record out any sooner?
Well, for us, for your fans, Billy.
What, are you still a fan?
Yeah, I'm still a fan, even after you've just attacked me.
Well, I can tell when I jumped in your lap.
Oh, please, but be realistic. Now,
why?
Billy, what's happening? Are you going to be touring again? Do we have a chance to see you live?
In December, yeah. December the 15th, I think, we're in Edinburgh, the 16th in Birmingham, and then the 20th and 21st, we're in Wembley in England.
I'm looking forward to it. One final thing. Pick a camera, any camera. Give us one of your favourite lip curls, will you, Billy?
Right, well, that one.
That'll do. Right. Good heavens. Yeah. And if you've just joined us, it's feeding time at the zoo, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much, Billy Idol.
Cheers, mate. Billy.
Ha ha ha.